Good morning. Welcome back. Today we'll go for some practical work in which we'll learn about two commands of MySQL. One is your create command, another is your insert command. Okay. Before executing this command, you should know about MySQL, how to run a MySQL. And I already shown you how to install and how to run MySQL. So when you open MySQL command line, at that time it will ask you the password. Okay, for the default user, that is the default user of the MySQL is root user. For that user, you have to give a password when you install the MySQL, and the password, whatever password you are given, that is the permanent password for that root user. And when we are opening MySQL command line, that time it will ask you the password. You have to enter the same password. If you are entering the password correctly, then the MySQL prompt will appear something like this. MySQL prompt appear, and all the commands, whatever be the commands you want to execute using MySQL, for creating database, creating table, inserting data, whatever be the command, you have to give all these command in MySQL. And one more thing you have to remember, each and every command is terminated by a terminator or semicolon. That means the end of the command is determined by the terminator or semicolon. If you are not mentioning, if you are not entering a semicolon, the command cannot be completed, or the system cannot understand that the command is completed. Now suppose for a simple command I am writing something like this, and after that put a semicolon, then press the enter key. Now when you pressing the enter key, at that time what happened, the command will execute at the prompt, and whatever be the output will be displayed over here. And if the command has any error, syntax error or any kind of error, then the error message will also appear in this position. And after the output, again the MySQL prompt will appear. Again, the MySQL prompt will appear. Now, if you are forgetting to enter the semicolon, then what happens? Suppose you are writing the complete command over here. You have written the complete command and you forgot to put a semicolon and you press the enter key, then don't need to be worried about this. After doing this, what happened? An arrow symbol will appear in this position. In that arrow symbol, simply put a terminator and press the enter key again. It will execute whatever be the command, that will be executed in that situation also. Okay, so these are the basic thing how to run and how to execute a command. Now go for the two commands I told you. First one is create command and second one is insert command. So first go for the create command. The create command is used to create a database, a table and a view. It used to create a database, a table and a view. Okay, so the create command is belongs to DDL, data definition language, and it used to create the structure of a table, the database itself and the view. So first, the database. What is database? The database is nothing than collection of table. More than one table are collectively known as the database. So first, we have to create a database, and within that database, we can create many tables as well as views. And table, you all know about the table. The table is nothing than a collection of rows and columns in which the data are stored in a organized way. Whereas the view is a virtual table, it doesn't exist in real life, or it doesn't exist really. It can be retrieved from one or more table. Either you can retrieve a view, or you can create a view from one table, or you can create a view in multiple tables. We'll later on learn about how to create a view and what is the use of view. So before that, for creating a database, we have to use the command create database and the database name. Here I am writing in capital letter as well as small letter, but practically there is no need of writing capital letter and small letter because MySQL commands are completely case insensitive. That means you can use smaller case, lower case, as well as you can use the uppercase, or you can use the small letter as well as the capital letter in case of the commands. But remember this thing, the MySQL data is highly case sensitive. That means data, if the data is in capital letter, then you have to mention each and every time in capital letter. You cannot change the case of the data. But commands are case insensitive, so that you can use small letter as well as the capital letter, whatever you want. But a smart idea or a smart good idea is to use the keywords in capital letter. Now the create is a keyword, database is a keyword, so I am using these keywords in capital letters, and the whatever be the user defined name or identifier, you can mention the identifier or user defined name, whatever, in small letter. Okay, so that after executing the command or after executing or after, if you are going through MySQL Python cell connecting Python connector, then what happens? You have to store the files. And once the files has been stored, later on when you see the file, you can identify what are the keywords we are using and what are the identifiers we are using. It is easy to maintain or easy to easy for correction purpose, all that thing we should use capital letters for keywords and small letters for identifier. It's a good practice, or it is a smart practice. Now the first command is create database and the database name. After that, press the enter key over here. This symbol is stands for the enter key. If I pressing the enter key, then if there is no problem, then it will show one row created or one database created like this. The message will appear and again will have the MySQL command. For example, suppose I want to create a table student, or suppose the table name is school. The database name is school. Then what happened? Create database school. School is the database name. Press the enter key over here. Now you get the output. That is one row created or one database created. Again you will get the MySQL prompt. Now if there is any problem, suppose I forgot to type this key. I just write CREAT database school. Now there is a mistake in this command. In this situation, what happened? It will show the commands, whatever written over here, it will show over here, and an asterisk mark appear at the bottom of the word in which the mistake or which the error has been appeared, and show you the message, an appropriate message. For example, suppose in this case we are using create, the spelling of create has been wrong. So what happened? It's shown an asterisk symbol here, and after the asterisk symbol it will show a command or show a message like this. There is no such keyword, or MySQL does not find any module create like that. A message will appear from which you can understand what is your error or what is the error in the command. Okay, if there is no error in your command, then the command will execute. Now this is how we can create a database. Now come to for a table. Once you have created a database, then you have to use another command, that is use database. That is your use database, the database name, that is school in our case. If you, after creating the database, if you are using use database school, then what happened? it will show you database change. The message appear database changed. Now that means you enter into your database tool. Now you can create table or view or you can do anything within that database. Now once the database has been created and the database has been used, now we can create a table. The table creation command, the same command create command is used for creating table. But in this case what happened? The syntax is create table, then the table name. Same, this create and table are the keywords, then the table name. You can give any table name, attribute, data type and the length. Attribute, which attribute and what type of data is going to store, whether it is integer, character, where character, date, time, or boolean values. Anything you can write in the data type and the length. Length is the width of the characters or width of the numbers or we can enter into the field, particular field. Now, comma, the second attribute is data type, length and so on. This dot 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 stands for you can enter many attributes in that particular way. Now go for the example. In this example, we have creating a database student. Yes, sir, we are creating a table student. That is create table. The table name is student. The first attributes is admission number ADM NO. The data type is integer and the length is 4. That means you can enter any whole number as admission number. That is maximum of 4 digits. You can enter 3 digit number or you can enter 4 digit number. But you cannot enter any 5 digit number in for this admission number. The next is name. The data type is varchar or variable length character. The length is 20. The next is roll number. Characters and the length is 6. So what is the difference between this character data type and varchar data type? I have already told you what is character and what is variable length character. In case of character data type, you are mentioning any attribute with character data type, then that is the fixed size for that attribute. In this case, roll number is a fixed size 6. That means at any case it will take 6 bytes of space in your memory. If you are storing only 2 digits as a roll number or 2 characters as a roll number, then also it will reserve 6 bytes. If you are storing 6 characters, then also it will reserve or it will take 6 bytes of value. But that can be solved using the varchar, in which the maximum length is 20. That means maximum you can enter 20 characters. But if you are entering 10 characters, then it will take 10 bytes. If you are entering 12 characters, then it will take 12 bytes of space. That is the difference between character and varchar. So now come to the example, that is create table student, admission number integer 4, name varchar 20 and the roll number, that is character 6. Now after this, put a semicolon, press the enter key, the table has been created, the message appear, one table created or one row created, the message will appear and again it will show you the MySQL prompt. Now, after the MySQL prompt has been shown or after the table has been created, the next thing is to insert value into the table. For that, we have to use the command insert command. The insert command can be used in two manners. The first way for the complete attribute, that means whatever attributes in your table, you have to enter values for all attributes. Or in other way, you can enter values for some attribute, you can skip some attribute for entering the value later on. Okay, so first, over the first session, that is for complete value set or complete attribute, the syntax is insert into table name. Insert is a keyword, into is a keyword, table name, whatever be the name of the table, values is a keyword, then the value set. Now come for the example. Now the same table, student table, if you want to enter value, then what happens? You have to write down insert into student values. the values are admission number is 19, 90 is the admission number, the name is Krishna Yadav and the roll number is S-1140 is the name. So when we are entering value into a particular table, remember that the data are highly case sensitive in case of MySQL. That means if you are entering data in uppercase, then each and every time you have to maintain the data in uppercase only. You cannot change it to lowercase. And the second thing is that whenever we are entering any text value, that means if the data type is character, or the data type is var character, or the data type is day, three things, character, varchar, and the day. If these three data types are of the attribute, then you have to use a single code for that particular data. That means the data must be enclosed within a pair of single code. As I done over here, in case of Krishna Yadav, it is written in single code. The roll number is also character. That's why the roll number is also written in a pair of single code. So this is one way of entering data in which we have three attributes, admission number, name and roll number, and I am entering value for each of these attributes. That is admission number, name and roll number. One more important thing you have to remember in this case, that is when we are entering values or when we are assigning these values, at that time you have to maintain the same sequence in which the table has the attribute. That means if your admission number is first, then the name, then the roll number, then you have to give the values, first value for admission number, second value for name, and the third value is for your roll number. That should not be mismatched. Sometimes if you are mismatching the sequence, then sometimes it will take a record, but the record was wrong. And sometimes it will show you a wrong an error message. For example, suppose here I am exchanging this admission number and your name. Suppose first I am writing Krishna Yadav, then I am writing 1940. Then what happened? It is not acceptable because the admission number has integer type and the Krishna Yadav is your varchar type. So it is not acceptable. In this case, you will have an error message. But if I am swapping between these two, Krishna Yadav and roll number, that is S 1140, both are character type, one is var character, another is character. In this case, sometime or many time or maximum of time it will accept the record, but the record was wrong, will be wrong. That means in case of roll number it will display the name, and in case of name it will display the roll number. So that you have to remember that you have to maintain the sequence over here. This is the way you can enter value for the complete record or the complete attribute. Now suppose I want to enter only over here, that is suppose the table has been created, student table. Now I want to enter data for admission number and your name. And later on, baad mein kabhi we can enter the roll number. In that case, we are skipping one attribute and entering values for two attributes. In that situation, you have to write down the attribute name within a pair of parentheses or bracket after the table name. For example, insert into student. The first attribute, I am writing admission number. The second attribute I am writing name, close the bracket, then values, again start the bracket, then write down the value. Suppose 2021 is the admission number and suppose Ram Kumar is the name. Now what happened over here? Now these two values, whatever values you are entering, the record will be created using these two values, and one record has been created having storing the admission number and the name, where the roll number will not stored in that particular case. But there is a problem with this kind of execution. You cannot skip the primary key. Whatever be the primary key of the table, you must have to enter value for primary key, because it cannot be skipped blank or it cannot be duplicated. So you have to enter primary key value. You cannot skip the primary key value. And the second thing is, the constraint is not null. If the constraint given to the table is not null, then also you cannot skip that field or that attribute. And the second issue that you have to remember for this kind of statement, that you have to maintain the sequence in which here the attributes are mentioned. Suppose here we are mentioning admission number first, then the name. So in case of the value, you have to enter admission number, next the name. You cannot change this sequence. So these are the two commands, that is the create command and insert command. In the next session, I will show you how to execute this insert command and create command using MySQL. And if you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me, and we feel free to ask your doubt. Thank you and have a wonderful day.